the specification of a DAC, the bit depth and sampling frequencies, total harmonic distortion, and so on and so forth, they proved to be very much uncorrelated with the quality of sound we would get. So more bits doesn't mean it is better in any way. It's actually the opposite. The simple explanation for that is it's not about the theoretical specification numbers. It's the actual execution of the DAC. How accurate is the DAC itself? The accuracy of this red R2R ladder resistor. How is this mechanism, the architecture is designed? And what's around that DAC, the power supplies, the output stages, everything around it, the materials and quality, that affects the DAC so much more than the number on the spec. The number on the spec sheet tells us only something about the theory. In practice, it's very different. So most DACs that I know, we've been measuring and looking at, especially those delta sigma noise shaping ones, they don't even produce an accuracy of 10 bits at the output. When somebody states a 32-bit resolution of a DAC, in the noise shaping terms, that's only the resolution of the demodulator, of the digital filter. The DAC itself accepts 1-bit signal. So one can connect the dots. We make 32 bits out of 1 bit. It's all been reconstructed. So the accuracy of a DAC and the specs, two different worlds. So the accuracy is the real world result. I think the easier analogy would be, you have a super race car that has a potential to break all the records. You put an amateur, a beginner race driver in that. You will never going to come even close to the record times. So all the specs of this super race car are not going to mean a thing. So the same very much with audio. You have a DAC that is high performance, but they put this DAC in a sort of very noisy environment with very noisy power supplies. The accuracy of the DAC is going to be below 5 bits. If you have a noisy environment, the bit depth means very little, means nothing. The idea is to what can we get out of that technology? How accurate can a DAC reproduce the musical information, and how close can this approximate the outcome to the analog recording? And in these terms, I think that what really stands out is that the TDA-1541 and TDA-1540 are very few of those sort of super DACs. The results correspond very close to the claimed numbers. So the 16-bit high performance, it's also written on the specs actually, TDA-1541, high performance DAC. We get very close to the 16 bits actually, as a result in practice. And with this thought in mind, we approach the DAC design. We ended up with the very well-known TDA-1541, 43, PCM-56 for those reasons.